It's a long way from Philly to Heidelberg, but the show must go on.
We're late, aren't we?
Yeah, we're late.
We all know there's nothing like the real thing. Luckily, we've got our best people on the job.
Oh, sorry, Josh. Josh, if you pulled your own weight, we wouldn't have to carry you through this place. Come on. I've been coming up hot for a minute.
There were many extremely interesting announcements related to data and analytics during SAP TechEd Virtual. Some of them are coming in Q1 of 2025, while others are already available. For example, you might have noticed that as technology continues to evolve, we've also brought SAP Analytics Cloud to Apple Vision Pro. We also announced new data lake capabilities for SAP DataSphere. These new capabilities, including Object Store, Spark Processing, and SQL on Files, will be available starting in Q4 2024. Looking like I'll need to develop new code gem exercises and hit the road with them in 2025. I've done a lot of code gems focused on getting started with HANA ML capabilities, and I'm already excited that the development of intelligent data apps will become even more efficient with the introduction of the generative AI toolkit for SAP HANA Cloud. I hope you've seen this in the announcements. Additionally, the new introduced knowledge graph engine in SAP HANA Cloud, combined with the accelerated factor engine, will be a powerful combo for building even more impactful AI-based applications using SAP data. So, lots of work and fun ahead. Stay with us.
Hola, SAP developers. Many announcements in the integration space as part of SAP TechEd 2024. So we have new integration adapters to easily connect to Anaplan, Coupa, HubSpot, NetSuite ERP, Snowflake, and more. We also have a new message status overview monitor. That's the aggregated overview of the status messages, for example, that we had in SAP process orchestration that we all love. The migration tool has been enhanced. Now it's possible to do mass migration of integration scenarios. There's a new licensing option for SAP Integration Suite, which is called Starter Edition. This is focused for grow with SAP customers and SAP SuccessFactors customers. Also, we have new generative AI capabilities in SAP Integration Suite, so we can now optimize our Groovy scripts in SAP Cloud Integration. And finally, the product SAP Event Broker for SAP Cloud Applications was recently renamed to SAP Cloud Application Event Hub. Apart from that, you can check out the documentation in CAP to see how you can easily connect your CAP application deployed to SAP BTP to the SAP Application Event Hub.
SAP announces several improvements to SAP Build, its comprehensive solution for extending S/4HANA Cloud and other line of business applications. The most significant updates enhance SAP Build by streamlining S/4HANA extension development, introducing new generative AI capabilities, and expanding access to ABAP development tools. A new extension wizard available now lets developers access SAP Build directly from S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition. With this access, developers can extend custom fields, business logic, and processes either on-stack or side-by-side. A critical feature of this integration is the knowledge of business context, such as events and objects, when creating business processes and while transitioning between S/4HANA and SAP Build. This preserves important business information, enabling developers to switch between environments seamlessly without losing crucial context. In Q4 2024, the extension wizard will let developers create SAP Fiori and SAP UI5 applications, leveraging the full set of features available in SAP Build. In Q4 2024, new capabilities such as code explanation and documentation search in SAP Build Code will reduce development time for Java and JavaScript developers. Low-code developers and business users will also be able to create user interfaces and automate workflows with assistance from Joule. Joule is SAP's generative AI assistant. In Q1 2025, ABAP developers will be able to generate high-quality code and unit tests with Joule that comply with ABAP development, cloud development model. Joule will also be able to generate explanations for legacy code, making it easier to modernize legacy code bases and migrate to a clean code. By end of Q4 2024, Joule will also be integrated into SAP Build Workzone, a low-code tool for creating engaging and personalized business sites. Joule's generative AI capabilities will offer user task automation and intelligence support. By end of 2024, developers will also be able to use low-code capabilities in SAP Build to enhance Joule with new skills, integrating it seamlessly with both SAP and non-SAP applications. This flexibility ensures Joule can be tailored to meet customer-specific business needs. Finally, developers can create applications that feature generative AI capabilities by taking full advantage of HANA Cloud to ground large language models using its vector engine. Soon, developers will also be able to achieve this S4HANA Cloud knowledge graph engine scheduled for general availability in the first half of 2025.
By the end of 2024, SAP Build will include access to ABAP development tools and ABAP development environments for SAP S4HANA Cloud and SAP BTP. New access from the SAP Build lobby, the solution's central starting point for all extension projects, will make it easier for multidisciplinary development teams, also known as fusion teams, to build extensions and custom processes across all technology stacks. Developers will also be able to create and monitor their ABAP cloud projects directly from SAP Build. This integration streamlines workflows by reducing the need to switch between different environments, significantly improving development efficiency.